Hello!
Welcome.
This is Adventure.
How are we doing?
Now, Andrew's always wanted to try a beer from this brewery, and the brewery is Wells & Young. But I said, Andrew, you already had Wells & Young.
No.
How about having a beer, Wells & Young, and Dogfish Head? He goes, who's Dogfish Head? Well, it's basically this dog that walks around with his fish head and brews beer.
I actually saw one of their little videos, and they did a gherkin one or something.
Oh, yeah.
Was it cucumber? I can't remember which one.
I think it was gherkin. This is a place in the area of the Dr. Shed Brewery, and they specialise in different variations of gherkin, aged in different styles of alcohol and preservatives.
But Dogfish out there like that, trying different
things. Yeah, ways. They've got one that uses Egyptian recipes.
Yeah.
As you can see on the bottle, this is expires 26th of November, so it expires Boxing Day. Now it's super hot outside here in Yorkshire, UK, and it's the 22nd of the 6th, 2014. But it is the Charles Wells & Young Dogfish Head Brewery Collaboration DNA. Now, DNA stands for Drinking Not Allowed. So Andrew won't be able to drink this beer, so I'll have to drink it myself. I'm joking.
Are you serious?
Apparently this is an Anglo-American ale, brewed with a reduction of their Dogfish Head 60-minute IPA, Well's traditionally English brewing company ingredients.
So it's not drinking now allowed.
Drinking now allowed. There you go.
There's a murky smell there.
A while back I had a 90-minute IPA from Dr. Shed, purchased it here in Yorkshire from one of the Yorkshire breweries, and also the 120-minute IPA, which I had at the Sparrow's second birthday, I think it was. Slight oppy caramel. It reminds me of Green King IPA.
Yeah, I'm thinking Green King. Because it has that almost tinny, almost.
Yeah, it's slight metallic in the aroma. You get a little bit of artificial mangoes, artificial peaches. Yeah, peaches, because I'm getting more peaches than mangoes now. I like tinned peaches.
Yeah, I mean, if you get a tin fill, you know what I mean? Peaches or something.
But
you smell the tin, you know what I mean? That's what you must get.
Yeah, artificial fruit and tin fruit.
Yeah.
Andrew a bit. Andrew making funny noises every time he gets poured.
Ding ding.
Ding ding.
Not special. It just comes off like a regular, like almost pale ale sort of thing, lager, almost.
It's not bad from Wells & Young. As you can see there, there's an eagle to represent America, and there's bright coloured green skies to represent London. So that's basically the sky around London, and that's America, the eagle.
Yeah.
We went to London earlier this year, and yes, that's what the skies look like.
Yeah.
See? Shake it up.
Is it? Come on.
You can get a little bit of sweetener colour in the head just there. It's just where it's off white, but it's like off tinged.
Comes off like almost a honeycomb colour to it.
It reminds me more of the Bombardier Gold, which I think they stopped making now.
Almost smells syrupy, you know what I mean?
Mm. Now, you think all effort between two breweries and they'd have a go effort making a cab what they do.
Yeah.
as the an Anglo-American. It's okay. I think we paid about $150 for it, but I think it was on a special buy. But as you can see there, it was the last one. So even though I tried to find more, but
we won't buy it again.
No, no, no. No. We've had it, and yeah. In fairness, I won't buy it again.
It's not outstanding there. It's no. Just
apparently it's really nice on tap, but that's here or there.
Yeah.
Apparently the bottle's being unbalanced. Some people say it's really nice, some people say it's really bad. And it's okay. Mm. Definitely check out Tesco's where we purchased it.
Yeah.
You take care.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.